am.
Now YouTube censor. Now YouTube censor.
I'm mad as hell right now. Yes, I am.
Your discretion is advised.
Mama Black.
This program contains language and sequences some viewers may find disturbing.
Tonight, a major break in a case that's been on the top of the FBI's priority list for the past month. Tonight, two men are behind bars for their alleged role in 10 violent robberies at Asian-owned businesses. The FBI saying that in some cases, the suspect fired shots, hitting employees and customers. Fox News' Natalie Fultz spoke with the FBI, who says that the public and Facebook played a big role in their investigation.
The FBI says they are confident these two suspects would have continued their crime spree. The FBI says they hit up 10 Asian businesses about every 5 days over a month-long period. FBI agents escort 22-year-old Davrion Ware from Atlanta Police Headquarters to the federal courthouse Wednesday afternoon for his first appearance. Ware and 22-year-old Tabyron Smith face federal charges for their alleged role in a slew of violent robberies at Asian-owned businesses.
These are serious federal charges, and there is really no parole in the federal system.
FBI Special Agent Steve Emmett tells me agents arrested the duo in the last 24 hours. This is surveillance video of a few of the robberies. Authorities say Ware and Smith robbed employees and customers, beat them, and in some cases, fired shots.
They were beating and shooting individuals inside these businesses, even though those individuals were complying. And one of those individuals is injured severely with a gunshot wound to the back.
The FBI says a tip from the public and information on social media pages played a key role in the investigation.
We did receive a very substantial tip that put us in the right direction.
I was lucky. I was one of the lucky ones. I only got one shot because they did not get to aim, you know, to shoot, because I reacted very fast.
A fast-moving father you see in this surveillance video fighting off men who tried to force their way into his Hollis, Queens home after staging a fake package delivery. It was Sunday afternoon. Takor Passad sent his 13-year-old son to answer the door, not knowing it was a setup. You can see right there a hooded man walked up with a package in hand.
Well, what struck me is when he tried to push me in the house. Why would a delivery guy push you in the house? And then after the other guy was coming up behind me, they looked strange. So I just pushed him with all my might, and they ran up the street.
Police now believe these hooded men are the same men responsible for pushing their way into an elderly couple's home in Bayside last week. The clue, the same M.O., hooded men with a package.
We have a lot on this case. Now, that case where they woke up with a parcel and try to get their way into the house like that happened the night before in the 113 precinct. So we think those two are linked.
Persaud was shot when the men targeted his home. He says a bullet is still lodged in his hip. Monday afternoon, Persaud and his 13-year-old son were returning home with detectives. As police zero in on these men who got away from here in a dark sedan with out-of-town plates.
Home invasions down, citywide are down very dramatically. It looks like this is a pattern that emerging out.
We have new information about a shooting involving a cop and a chase with multiple law enforcement agencies involved. This video shows how it all came to an end early this morning near Buffalo in Union County. Spartanburg police say it started in the city. An officer eventually shot that suspect. That officer noticed a suspicious car behind the Big Lots on Cedar Springs Road and realized the vehicle was reported stolen. He found out that the driver was also wanted for a parole violation. Police say the man didn't follow orders and it ended with the officer shooting the driver in the shoulder. According to the police, the driver took off, leading Spartanburg County deputies on a chase into Union County, where he eventually pulled over. That is where the Union County Sheriff David Taylor tells us that James Kershaw is facing a charge of failure to stop for blue lights. According to the officer, Kershaw wouldn't get out of the vehicle. Now, deputies noticed the vehicle's rear window shot out. They eventually broke the rest of that glass. EMS took Kershaw to the hospital for treatment. Kershaw is now at the detention center facing parole violation charges from the city of Spartanburg. However, more charges are on the way. Police say the officer who fired the gun is on administrative leave while SLED investigates.
Killeen police have arrested five people they say tried to rob a homeowner at gunpoint, and the whole thing was caught on camera. The victim, who lives off Willow Spring Road in Killeen, says someone broke her window Saturday night. That man knocked on her door asking if she was okay. Moments later, this happened. A group of masked men tried to rob her at gunpoint. Now, police have arrested four adults and one juvenile. The adults are identified as 17-year-old Javian Smith-Williams, 22-year-old Davion Reed, 18-year-old Jamal Marbury Jr., and 18-year-old Daquan Levant.
New tonight, Rocky Mounts police arrested three people and are looking for a fourth in connection to a shooting in the mall parking lot that injured a woman across the street in the Walmart parking lot. Now, all three men are facing gang-related charges. The injured woman is expected to recover.
And As always, thank you for watching. If you like this video, please consider subscribing. Also, follow us on the usual media for more and interesting information like this.
Fight their asses.